wewe. Wacha. Ani super so. Ani super so. Story yetu Anbela. Anbela.
Hello ladies. How do you feel being part of this university generation whereby once you post your relationship status online, your boyfriend is spotted, friend requested, ruled and snatched away from you such that you're only left with one job, being an online motivational speaker.
But how do you feel being part of this university generation where ladies take 110 selfies, delete 70, edit 39, then post one with a caption, a random one, full of animal features, a dog's mouth, a hyena's ears, and opaque emojis at appropriate places. Here, here, yeah.
Lakini wanaume pale Instagram. It is during these university times that we met Annabelle. First day in university, first lecture, seated front row, just near the lecturer's pulpit.
Annie, super so, story yetu Annabella.
Now, Annabelle was this low-key, ordinary lady who did her things ordinarily. In fact, she was an average girl with average looks, average behavior. We didn't even notice that she was around. But this was until third year.
Ish!
My
friend, while all other ladies were dressing to kill, Annabelle dressed to resurrect all of us.
While all of us were meeting in the library doing assignments, borrowing encyclopedias, googling all night.
Tafuta Annabelle.
She was not there.
While all of us were busy in the library doing research, borrowing encyclopedia, googling all night.
Where were Tafuta to Annabelle?
She was not there.
Now, where was Annabelle? Because Annabelle was never in school, she was never in the hostel, neither was she in her father's house.
In fact, when all of us were busy in the cut room, trying to cope up with all acrobatic styles, copy and exams, sliding down the chair and back, mixing all the facial expressions that we are blessed with, scratching our heads, scratching our armpits, scratching our stomach, scratching our...
Watcha! Where were Tafuta to Annabelle?
She was not there!
Now, Annabelle was never in school. You will not find her in her hostel. She was never in her home. Who was she with? Where was she?
Annabelle was all over.
Where?
In the social media.
Doing what?
Annabelle Malindi.
Annabelle Villarosa.
Annabelle Madagascar.
Annabelle Sarova.
Annabelle Kuala Lumpur.
Kuala Lumpur. Google! Did you know that Kuala Lumpur is an Asian name of a town in Malaysia? I thought you should know.
And as if this was not enough,
just imagine Annabelle was paying us to do assignments,
sit for her cuts,
attend a group discussion,
and sign the class attendance list on her behalf.
2 weeks to the main exam.
While we were on our way home from the library, on the right-hand side, a borrowed encyclopedia, photocopied notes, and a Kenya. On the left-hand side, an Infinix phone, borrowed calculator, and more Kenyas.
Pipi!
Aye. Nisisi Kwed.
But this was a BMW X6 KCM009X latest model.
Ah, bana.
Pipi again, eh. Two well-fed men somersaulted out of the car with eyewitness sunglasses and tight-fitting trousers that depicted the Rikomond himself.
And he grabbed their waist. You know this version of bouncers who just look at you and get angry for no good reason, then force you to look as if you're drunk before they use their huge hands to massage your head, to massage your shoulder, to massage your stomach, to massage your...
Watch out! Before we could even take off, they led us to the car. Guess who was in the car?
It was Annabelle Watare Mutamu. Mwah. Our classmate.
My friend in the car, Annabelle, was looking extremely beautiful.
Annabelle was stinking money.
Annabelle was a business mogul.
Annabelle was a princess merchant.
In fact, she was wearing this expensive thigh-high boot with a golden heel.
What was she trying to do? Was she trying to intimidate our financial position?
What was she trying to imply? Was she trying to imply that we didn't even know what we were doing with our lives? Was it?
That is when we decided to throw away all our thoughts and inquire.
Annabelle,
surely,
where have you been? What are you doing for a living?
Annabelle did not say anything, but she handed us her business cards. Believe it or not, Annabelle was a CEO.
My friend, CEO of a fully registered company.
Annabelle and Sisters Comfort and Escort Services Company Limited.
Wanaume.
Comfort Escort Services. Asante.
And mark you, she was still a student just like us.
Annabelle then asked if we could join her to our workstation where she was having a show at 12 of midnight. That same night. Sisi.
We were free. We were idle. And in fact, that night we didn't even know what we were doing with our lives.
20 minutes later, we were at
Wine and Coach Ricochet Club.
What is that, man?
Wine and Coach Ricochet Club now. Wine and Coach Ricochet Club was the venue where Annabelle and Sisters Comfort and Escort Services Company Limited were having their shows. And never forget, that same night, Annabelle had a show at 12 a.m. midnight.
And at the entrance of the bar, we bumped into a polite notice. We escort men to high-end places and offer extra comfort services.
Wanaume.
Tena.
Extra comfort services. Asante.
And below this polite notice was also another polite notice. The only difference was, this other polite notice was written in red.
Jokers will face the wrath of the bouncers.
My friend, you will be spotted. You will be isolated. Your future will be grabbed and massaged before you are deported out of the venue. Immediately.
We were privileged to be at the VIP. What we saw made us swear by our grandmother's sweet name on top of our ancient grave that we'll never ever tell anybody, not even ourselves.
This why university ladies,
very young, energetic and beautiful university girls.
These university ladies had tags on their waist with the numbers that presented their age, and most of them aged between 18 to 23 years. Imagine. Lakini DJ pale kwa kona.
Bibuta mama, I need your company. Give my you the way Kenya Jabel. I'm still in love for you. I'm still in love for you.
These university ladies were shaking things in a manner I had never imagined a university lady of the age would shake before in public.
Little did I know that this was annoying the men. The men became ruthless. They started slapping the ladies.
Despite being slapped, these university ladies went ahead and touched the floor in a manner I had never imagined a university lady of the age would bend, touch and shake it with the public.
The men became even more annoyed one. They became more ruthless. In fact, they stood up.
Okay, not literally.
And slap the ladies.
But these ladies were abnormal. Imagine despite being slapped,
they were not crying.
No.
They were happy. We get even more annoyed. Rushed to Annabelle's office. And looked her straight in the eyes. And asked her, Annabelle, huh? Annabelle, what is this? Annabelle, is this what you're doing in Nairobi? Annabelle, is this what you're using to intimidate our financial position?
Annabelle never wanted us to expose that she was running an illegal business. Therefore, she offered us a contract, and this was our terms and conditions. Term number one.
For every subscriber you bring, it will earn you a 20% commission per subscription.
Term number two.
You are entitled to 35,000 Kenyan shillings basic salary.
Now, suppose we market Annabelle and Sisters Comfort and Escort Services Limited Company online and make it trend. Of course, thousands of people will come to the club due to the state of euphoria.
Now, of the thousands of people talking about it online, suppose 200 people subscribe. Let us do these simple arithmetics. 200 people times the 1,000 regular subscription fee amounts to 200,000 Kenyan shillings. 20% commission times the 200,000 Kenyan shillings amounts to 40,000 Kenyan shillings untaxed. 20 in 1 week.
In 1 month. Sisi, lecturer's salary.
In 1 year. Sisi, showroom, Subaru.
And
That is when we shall search within ourselves and realize that we were struggling students, both academically and financially. Therefore, this was a good idea.
But this was illegal. Therefore, we had no option but to decline the contract and rush back to the VIP.
Mark you, the show was still on. At exactly 11:45 p.m.
A selected man was wheeled to the podium, shirtless and the face covered by a veil.
And now at exactly 12 midnight.
Watch out! My friend, if you continue laughing,
as always, you will be spotted. You will be isolated. Your future will be grabbed and massaged before you are deported out of the venue immediately.
Guess who? It was Annabelle Watare Mutamu. Mwah! Our classmate. As she walked towards the light, she was preceded by the intoxicated smell of the almonds and rose perfume. She wore a leather choker that accentuated her long neck. Silver chains dangled from the choker, perfectly creating a link to her red corset bra, which gave her round bosom a perfect boost.
She had a short leather miniskirt that leaves little to imagination. The thigh-high leather boots added length to her already long spot legs, giving her body a perfect pose. In Annabelle's hand was a leather whip. She looked at us, looked at the VIP guests, then let out a loud whisper.
Shall we begin?
By this time, all the men were standing up in a manner that only you, yes, especially where, are thinking about.
The show had just begun.
Yeah!
Spread out the leather whip.
Yeah!
Annabelle tippy-toed and got closer to the selected man.
Yeah!
Annabelle whipped the leather wing in the air.
Yeah!
Annabelle whipped the selected man.
This cry made Annabelle a little bit uncomfortable because to her it seemed familiar. So she hurriedly took off the veil.
Uncle Joseph!
Ladies and gentlemen, believe it or not, the selected man was Annabelle's uncle, her father's younger brother, Joseph.
Annabelle? Is this the cost I've been paying your school fees for? Is this the class trip? Annabelle, is this the class group discussion? I must say I'm disappointed in you.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the regular subscribers was heard shouting from the back.
We pay you to get practical on stage and you bring your family issues on stage and you expect us to go. We are not going.
We are going, Bona. Where is our money?
Where is our show?
Annabelle Ninani!
Next morning, Annabelle's face was all over the social media, and that is how she faced social media criticism.
Little did we know that the school academic department had launched an impromptu investigation to curb exam cheating, and we were found guilty of exam irregularity and misconduct, and we were served with 1,000 academic day suspension of university.
To restore sanity in town, Wine and Coach Ricochet Club was closed. Annabelle and Sisters Comfort and Escort Services Limited Company was disbanded, rendering Annabelle jobless.
However, due to the strong impact Annabelle had on the youth and the massive social media following, the Kitu ni Kukachora sponsors.
What do you say, man?
Kitu ni Kukachora sponsors.
Sema vizuri banaoni sponsors wa drama.
Kitu ni Kukachora.
Correct.
They approached Annabelle and asked if she could spearhead a youth empowerment program that enlightened the youth on social welfare and good conduct. And this changed Annabelle's life positively.
And by the way, Uncle Joseph is now newly married.
Yeah.
And here we are, jobless.
But using our talent to entertain at the Kenya National Drama Festival as we await our 1,000 academic day suspension to expire.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, join us as we celebrate
a lesson well learned. Jiggy, 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 jamama, hey! A Professor Klaus Berry production.
Annabelle!
Eh, 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 eh.